This is Spoken Gospel. We're dedicated to seeing Jesus in all of Scripture. In each episode, we see what's happening in a biblical text and how it sheds light on Jesus and his gospel. Let's jump in. The Israelites were chosen by God to be an example to the rest of the world of God's goodness and justice. But Israel abandoned that calling and created a society full of inequity, evil, and bloodshed. In a series of four prophecies, Ezekiel demonstrates that every level of Israelite society deserves to be exiled for their rebellion against God. Ezekiel starts at the top. His first prophecy is for Israel's king. In a series of prophetic signs, Ezekiel says Babylon will soon invade, pack up the king's belongings, break down his walls, and escort him to Babylon, where he and those who defend him will die. In another prophecy, Ezekiel eats a meal in a public square while violently shaking. It's another sign. Once the king is carried off, the survivors will eat every meal in anxiety and fear as their nation crumbles around them. Moving down Israel's social ladder, Ezekiel's second prophecy is directed towards religious leaders who have denied God's warnings of exile. For decades, the Jewish religious elite have dismissed any prophecies of political disaster. At the same time, influential women in Israel were selling magic charms that promised to ward off any coming destruction. Unlike Ezekiel, the religious leaders and these influential women consistently prophesied peace in Israel despite its growing depravity and corruption. But God says all these presumptions will quickly be proven wrong. Israel's prophets are liars. The prophecies of false peace they've peddled are no better than putting a coat of plaster on a rotting wall. God says he will pierce their false prophetic narratives with Babylonian swords and personally ensure they do not survive the coming exile. Nearer to the bottom of society, Ezekiel's third prophecy is directed at Israel's hypocritical clan leaders. While they frequently make a show of asking God for advice, most only ask for God's opinion after they've already consulted other gods. In doing so, Ezekiel says they have given their hearts to beings other than the God who chose them. Ezekiel denounces their blended spirituality in hopes of winning Israel's hearts back to the God who chose them. If Israel's clan leaders refuse to end their hypocrisy, Ezekiel says God will destroy both them and the prophets who pretend to give them answers. Finally, Ezekiel addresses the average citizen of Israel who has followed their leader's evil example. Their leaders have so poisoned the people that there is no one left who can hold back the tide of national destruction and exile. And soon Babylon will descend and root out evil from Israel. While there will be some survivors, Ezekiel says even they will continue in their evil stubbornness and prove to the world that Israel deserves their exile. After these prophecies, we're meant to conclude that from top to bottom, Israel is corrupt, and God is right to destroy this evil kingdom and send it into exile. There is no one left in Israel who can stop the coming exile. Everyone is corrupt, from the king to his subjects. But the purpose of Ezekiel's prophecies is to cause repentance. Ezekiel's only prophesying what will happen if Israel does not change course. And tragically, Israel does not repent. And just as he prophesied, Babylon came and destroyed it. And eventually, God sends another prophet to demonstrate the corruption of Israel's society from top to bottom. And his name is Jesus. Jesus claimed to be a king of a higher kingdom than that of Rome. And Jesus told the religious leaders of his day that God sent him to judge them. Through his ministry, Jesus rebuked Israel's religious leaders for their hypocrisy, injustice, and stubborn hearts. And like Ezekiel, he calls them plastered tombs that look good on the outside, but are full of the bones of those they victimized. And to the average citizen of Israel, Jesus says he came not to bring a false narrative of peace, but a sword that would divide evil fathers from faithful sons and good mothers from their evil daughters. Ezekiel prophesied that Israel's evil would lead to their nation's destruction. But Jesus prophesied something even more horrifying. He warned of an exile from God and his land that would last beyond death for anyone who persists in their evil. Ezekiel and Jesus' prophecies demonstrate that we deserve exile, but they are also not inevitable outcomes. When we hear these stark warnings from Jesus, they are actually mercies designed to provoke our repentance. When we repent and give our hearts to Jesus, he actually cleanses us from evil and destroys our rebellion. In his grace, he will forgive our past, and in his mercy, he will spare us from exile to be a people who demonstrate to the world God's goodness and justice. Thankfully, God's decision to exile those who reject him is always slow. And God is patiently waiting so that rebellious people will have time to hear his message. God doesn't want any of his people to be separated from him. That's why he warns us through prophets like Ezekiel and Jesus. So, listen to Jesus' warning. Repent, and you'll be saved from a coming exile. I pray that the Holy Spirit will open your eyes to see the God who will inevitably destroy human corruption and evil by exiling it from this world. And may you see Jesus as the one who cleanses us of evil and makes us his people.